Alright, hi Emo.
Hi, Stephen.
How has your time been over the past couple months teaching online?
It's been different, right? You can see from my hair, it's evolving.
And have you been able to interact with your students as much as you would have in school?
No, I definitely haven't. That's been a challenge. It's been a little bit difficult.
Yes, and I found the same. On a typical class of 40, 41 students, I probably only get 19, 20 students turning up for an online class. And it's a little bit taxing because now you have to think about what about the rest of the students? This isn't very inclusive.
But more so, it's also a management issue for me because when you have so many students showing up, it's a bit difficult, even trying to conceptualize how do I manage so many children in one activity in one space.
Right, yes, of course. So what I've tried is a method of teaching where I don't have to be online all the time. It's asynchronous, but I still get the students to submit assignments and to complete work, and they don't have to be online at the same time. And I think it has been successful for me on my part, and it has worked with various form levels as well, form one, two, and three so far. And I think it could be successful for other applications as well. And that is Padlet. Have you ever heard about Padlet?
I've seen the word floating around. I can't say that I've actually used the software myself.
Well, Padlet is a website that acts kind of like a virtual notice board. The students would be able to write on a notepad and take that and stick it up, but in a virtual sense. So it's actually a very good tool because it's also real time. In other words, whatever they put up on that Padlet, I can see as they do it. And I used it in teaching a unit on rainforests. And I thought it was very successful in engaging the students in learning about rainforests. So, for example, what I did was I created several different Padlets. And each Padlet had a different lesson dealing with the rainforest. So what they do is visit that particular Padlet and they look at the content I wanted them to look at. And then they complete activities based on what I put there. And when they are finished with the activities, they update the Padlet one time. And I would be able to see as they update the Padlet what they are doing. And I thought that was very helpful to me because in real time, I could go on and see who's completing the work and who may be behind a little bit. And I could go and talk to them, message them, and say, listen, maybe you need to try doing some work or try getting online sometime and do it. But the key thing is the Padlet is always there. And any student who is not online can come later on and still complete the same activity on the Padlet. So it's a very asynchronous design. Yes.
But I was just wondering, Stephen, isn't it that all of the students can see each other's work as well?
Yes, the students can see each other's work on Padlet as well. And each of the different notifications that they stick up there, they'll be able to look at it. And what I have used it for is peer assessment. So I ask the students to go online and look at their fellow peer work, and I gave them a rubric. And they were able to use the rubric to assess whether that student completed the work to a satisfactory con to satisfaction. And the thing is, they were able to comment on each other's work and say, listen, maybe you could improve in this way, or I like this about your work. And I thought that was very helpful to them because it helps develop their idea about how they should do their own work as well. Because they were able to not only criticize each other, but look at themselves and criticize themselves.
Yeah, evaluation is a very high order thinking skill, and it's really allowed for that. So on the Padlet, and I'm just curious about design of the Padlet now, is it that you put up the lesson content and then each student, so you had 40 students and each one was able to upload their responses. So you had 40 responses and the Padlet was able to hold all of that.
Well, the Padlet can hold up to 10 megabytes of data at a time. But how I worked it out was instead of 40 students working, I had them work in groups of four. And each group completed an activity. And how they did it, there was a PowerPoint for them to download from the Padlet, and the Padlet had all the instructions of what you do on the PowerPoint. So on PowerPoint now, they could work together online on Google Slides or Google Docs to complete it. And they would fill in tables, they would put in diagrams, they would create concept maps on the PowerPoint, and then upload the PowerPoint back onto Padlet. So I was able to see the direction they were going in when they completed the PowerPoint. And so what I also found is that it allowed them to be very creative. And the creativity came out a lot in when they were able to talk, to do a lot more story writing, a lot more English-related topics. Like, they used tools like personification. They had some interesting metaphors. And I thought that detail would not normally come out in a traditional classroom, because there's only so much time we could question them. Even on an online forum like Zoom or Google Meet, we would only question them so much. But by seeing they put it together, I was able to see that their creativity came out in that sense.
I like that you were able to merge together several pieces of software and utilize it. That gives a lot of flexibility. And then having the students, you know, create things to upload really shows a different level of interacting with content and material. And it's not easy to bring that across online, you know, if you do not have the right design and the right software, you know. So why did you choose Rainforest? You know, was it did you think that this was just better suited to this method, or is it that you felt like any topic could work with this?
Well, I think a lot of topics can work with Padlet, but one of the problems we have is finding sufficient content that is of good quality and at the level that students are able to read and interpret. And this unit was done at the Form 2 level. And what I saw was that there were lots of videos from National Geographic, from news agencies, as well as a lot of reading material that was simple enough for them to access. So Rainforest served as a very good pilot project for me to use Padlet. And when I put it there, I was actually surprised, because I was not only able to put basic reading, but I was also able to put some more advanced reading. And on the Padlet, I stated, if you are finished with this, if you would like, you could go ahead and read this. And a lot of students accessed the advanced reading and was able to put quotes and use the information in doing the activities as well. So the topic of Rainforest was very appropriate in this, especially with the fires that have been happening in Australia and in the Amazon. And what really surprised me was that they were able to translate all of this to other rainforest areas in the world, such as in Borneo, Indonesia. They look at the animals and the biodiversity. And that itself showed me I could not have completed this in class if I were to have just a lecture. I couldn't tell them about all these animals, all these peoples in the different rainforests. It was just too much content. But because Padlet was allowing them to look at what they wanted to look at, which is a type of discovery-based learning, essentially, they got more covered than I would ever have covered in class.
I especially like that you were able to scaffold that information for the different levels of learning, because, again, one of the challenges is, who am I catering to in different learning styles and, you know, abilities?
Yes, it could be a good way to differentiate learning, because you could either have different types of information on one Padlet, or you could create several Padlets with the same content but in different formats for different learning styles. And then when you think one of them has reached the position where they can now handle the other type of information, you can transfer them across to that Padlet. So it's very versatile in that manner.
Yeah, that's great. And you know, I like the collaboration.
Yes. Okay. Well, hopefully that was a little bit helpful. Thanks very much.
Yeah, thanks, Stephen, for sharing.